everybody. How are you? It's me, Miss Rosemary from Corona Library, and I want to welcome you to Earth Day Storytime. Earth Day is actually tomorrow. I'm a little early. It's better early than late. And I just wanted to give a couple of words about QPL before we start. So you may know, and you may not know, but QPL is now open for to-go service at a whole bunch of libraries. We're opening more and more every week, it feels like. And with QPL's to-go service, you can pick up and return material at dozens of our locations. To learn more about the to-go services and the virtual QPL programs, to find out which branches are open, and to access digital services or get an e-card, visit queenslibrary.org. And there you'll be able to get an e-card. Please remember, you cannot get a library card in the branches right now. We're not taking applications. So the only way to do it for now is to go to queenslibrary.org and get an e-card. Once you get that, then you can come with picture ID to any one of the open branches, and we'll be able to pull that up and give you an actual card. You can borrow ebooks with the e-card. You can actually reserve and take out regular, you know, like actual books with the e-card number. But if you want an actual library card, that's what you got to do. All right. Queens residents come from more than 100 countries and speak more than 100 languages. And at Queens Public Library, we speak diversity. Join us as our library honors immigrant heritage this month. And for the entire year, QPL is celebrating its 125th anniversary. So visit QPL125.org to get involved. Queens Public Library is proud to have served the people of Queens since 1896, providing customers with the resources they need to advance in their lives. And I am very proud to have been a Queens Library cardholder since I was 5, starting out at Elmhurst, then moving over to Jackson Heights. And actually now my home branch is Rego Park and I work at Corona. So, okay. So today is our Earth Day story time. And I've got some really good books. I've got some fun songs and finger play. And I have a little word about how to make a really cool nature journal. So first, we're going to start off with our hello song. So for that, all we need is our two hands. And we're going to clap and sing, hello, my friends, hello. Hello, my friends, hello. That's it. All right, so we're going to give it a try. Here we go. Hello, my friends, hello. Hello, my friends, hello. Hello, my friends. Hello, my friends. Hello, my friends. Hello. See, it was that easy. You did it. All right. Now, I thought we'd do a fun song for Earth Day and about leaves. We normally sing it with a scarf, but today we're going to do it with a leaf. We're going to. You can use a scarf. I've said before, you can use a sock. You can use a t-shirt. You can use your washcloth, a pillowcase, whatever you have. I just happen to have a scarf today. So we're going to sing one bright leaf waiting for the wind to blow, right? Because they hang out in the trees kind of waiting. And it's going to wiggle it high because the wind shakes it up. And then wiggle it low as it falls, right? And it wiggles fast if it's really windy. Or wiggles slow as it drops down. And then when it falls, where'd it go? You ready? Here we go. One bright leaf waiting for the wind to blow, wiggling high and wiggling low, wiggle fast and wiggle slow. Where did it go? I don't know. You want to do it one more time? Come on, we'll do it one more time. It's a lot of fun. One bright leaf waiting for the wind to blow, wiggling high and wiggling low, wiggle fast and wiggle slow. Where did it go? Great job! All right. All right, now we're going to start our first book. And this is a super fun one. And it's called Earth, My First 4.54 billion years, because that's how old it is. Imagine how many candles you'd need. So this is by Stacy McAnulty, who has written a lot of really fun books. She's written one about the sun, and she's written one about Mars, and she's written one about the oceans. So this is all in that series. And David Litchfield has drawn the pictures, and Henry Holt is giving me permission to read this book. So what do we say? Thank you. And see that smiley face? That's a happy Earth. That's what we like for Earth Day, right? Okay, now if you'll give me a second, I'm going to take the jacket off so I don't crumple it up while I'm reading. And look, there's an even happier Earth. Oh, look, it's kind of giggling. Oh, and the stars. Earth, my first 4.54 billion years by Earth with Stacy McAdulty. Illustrated by Earth and David Litchfield. Here we go. Hi, my name is Earth. Some people call me Gaia, the world, or the third planet from the sun, the blue marble. You can call me Planet Awesome. My family is really, really big. See, like there's their holiday card. Happy holidays. So let's see. We've got, itty bitty Pluto. And we have Mercury, Venus, Mars, there's Earth, Saturn, Jupiter, Neptune, and Uranus. I have 7 siblings, that's brothers and sisters, in my solar system. I'm closest to Venus and Mars. Some used to say I have 8 siblings, but Pluto is more like the family pet. And then there are my cousins. My Milky Way family has billions of planets. Told you, big family. My favorite things to do are spinning. It takes me a whole day to go around once. Who else loves to spin? Do you love to spin around till you get dizzy? Oh, come on, that's fun. Don't do it now, please. I don't want to get anybody in trouble. Okay. It takes me a whole day to go around once. And circling the sun, that takes me an entire year. My best friend is the moon. Who's your best friend? What do you do with your best friend? Well, with Earth, Earth and the moon hang out all the time, even when you can't see her. The moon needs 27 days, 7 hours, 43 minutes, and 12 seconds to go around me. I've timed her. I was born 4.5 billion years ago. I don't remember what it was like to be a baby. Who does? But I've been told I was a hot mess. Explosive, gassy, very cranky. Why don't you ask Mommy and Daddy what you were like? I'm sure you were a perfect baby. Then I started to cool off and things got wet. Really wet. It rained for thousands of years. I'm not kidding. Thousands. I was soggy and lonely. A few islands popped up in my oceans, but no plants or animals. My islands must have been lonely too. They got together and made bigger islands called continents. There's one called Pangaea. That's what happened before all the pieces of land broke apart. They were all together. I remember Ur and Nuna and the ginormous Pangaea. Then Pangaea split into 7 separate continents. North America, that's where we are. Europe, Asia, South America, Africa, Australia, and Antarctica. Things are always changing. As I got older, stuff began to grow. Almost half my life, you probably wouldn't even recognize me, though I've always been round. 2,400,000,000 years ago, air! If anyone had been alive, they could finally take a breath. 470 million years ago, life! Plants that can live on land. 400 million years ago, and then came bugs. 240 million years ago, my first dinosaur. 210 million years ago, yay for mammals, they're fuzzy and warm. 150 million years ago, birds. Did you know they are relatives of dinosaurs? 130 million years ago, flowers. I'm a very pretty planet. It's not bragging if it's true. 200,000 years ago, Homo sapiens. You humans have big brains and walk on 2 feet.
Hi.
The time of the dinosaurs was one of my favorites. I mean, everyone loves dinosaurs. They lived with me for 175 million years until... Asteroid! It's not always easy being Earth. Volcanic eruptions, ice ages, major collisions. But on the inside, I'm the same planet awesome. And there's the picture of what it looks like. There's the crust, the mantle, the inner core, and the outer core. So that's all going on inside our Earth. Humans have been super fun. No other species has been interested in learning about me. Other animals are nice, but they mostly eat and poop and never wonder about my amazing life. But sometimes humans forget to share and play nice and clean up after themselves. Still, I bet you humans will turn out to do really great things. We love you, Earth, and we love the Earth, don't we? The end. So let's give Earth a big hug. Oh, thank you, Earth. So I hope you liked that. And I thought we could do a song that everybody knows on a finger play about one of our, one of the buggies. Well, it's not really a buggy, it's an arachnid. But one of our Earth friends, get your twig, your spider fingers out, and we're going to sing. The itsy bitsy spider went up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the itsy bitsy spider went up the spout again. You did a great job. How about some twinkle fingers now? All right. Because we saw that beautiful stretch of starlit sky in Earth. Here we go. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. You did it! I'm really proud of you! Okay, our next book is The Seedling That Didn't Want to Grow. You know, sometimes maybe think back to if you started school and you were a little nervous about starting school and you weren't ready to grow up yet, right? You didn't want to leave mom or dad, or you didn't want to leave anybody just yet. Or even if you've been in school for a while, there's just some days where you don't want to be grown up. There's some days I don't want to be grown up. Yeah, well, that's what happens to this little seedling. So we're going to read about the little seedling that didn't want to grow. And this is by Britta Teckentrup. And she's one of my favorite storytellers. We've got a lot of her books in the library. And she just creates beautiful art and wonderful stories. And Prestel is her publisher. And they're giving me permission to read this. So we say thank you. All right, let's go. The Seedling That Didn't Want to Grow. And I see a couple of buggies here. It looks like a beetle of some sort. And I see an ant, and I see a ladybug. So maybe, do you think maybe they'll become friends with the seedling and help the seedling grow? Could be. Let's find out. It was spring, and all of the seeds in the ground were ready to grow. Does it look like that around you? Yeah? They all grew tall and straight, just as they were supposed to. All but one little seed hadn't grown at all. I wonder what's wrong, said Ladybird. Ladybird is another way of saying ladybug. Let's just sit next to her and wait. Maybe she needs more time, replied Ant. Ant was right. Very soon, the seed grew small roots and tiny green leaves started to appear. Her life was about to begin. She looked so delicate and fragile. Aunt and Lady Bird fell in love with her immediately. It was dark on the meadow ground. By now, other plants had grown so tall and wide that they blocked out all of the sunshine. So the little seedling began her journey in search of the sun. "Let's go with her," said Aunt, "because that's what plants do. You can try that as a super easy experiment at home. If you turn your plant toward the window, if you turn it away, it will start moving toward the sun." The seedling grew fast, and soon the animals of the meadow came to join her on the difficult adventure. Aunt and Lady Bird were so proud of their brave little friend. Look, there she goes. The seedling changed with every day. Tiny leaves turned into bigger leaves. She formed deep roots and grew stronger and stronger. The seedling had become a little plant and was weaving and winding her way through the undergrowth. Her friends were always by her side and helped the best they could. Crickets guarded her roots. Mouse searched for the easiest paths ahead. And butterfly and ladybird flew high above, trying to find the perfect spot for her. Finally, the day arrived when the meadow undergrowth became thinner. For the first time, the little plant could feel the warm summer sun on her leaves. She knew this spot would be the perfect place. And then everything happened quickly. The little plant grew taller and taller and branched out. Buds started to appear, and they soon transformed into hundreds of blossoms. The little plant wasn't so little anymore. Her friends watched her transformation in amazement. Look at that, everyone. Through the long, hot days of summer, she was the happiest plant there could be. All kinds of animals lived among her many leaves. She was full of love and life. Many weeks and months passed by, and the days started to get shorter and colder. Autumn was around the corner. Now, think about what happens to plants. Do they kind of go to sleep? Let's see. The leaves of the plant had turned as golden as the October sky, and she was gently swaying in the autumn breeze. As the leaves were beginning to wilt and fall to the ground, something magic happened. The wind blew all of her seeds far and wide. And then everything turned gray and cold. It was time for the final goodbye. Little Mouse made a wish. "I wish that I will see you again," she whispered with a tear in her eye. Snow covered the meadow like a soft blanket, and everything went silent. Winter seemed to last forever. Until it was spring again, and all of the new seeds in the ground were ready to grow. So she spread all her seeds out, and they came back. So her friends were sad, but then they were happy again when they saw that she lived on. And think about how friendly they were and what they did for her. They supported the plant, and they helped find ways for her to grow and expand. And think about the people that do that for you in your life. I bet you can think of a bunch. All right. Now we're gonna do a song about litter. You guys know what litter is? It's junk on the street. You know, when you finish drinking your juice box, do you throw it on the sidewalk? No. Would you get away with that at home, just throwing it on the floor? Absolutely not. So it goes into the garbage, just like papers, just like anything that doesn't belong on the ground, right? Plants belong on the ground. So we're going to sing a song called "See the Litter, Pick It Up." And that's pretty much it. So it goes, "See the litter, pick it up, pick it up. See the litter, pick it up. Keep the earth clean. Make sure to recycle, recycle, recycle. Make sure to recycle, keep the earth clean. You want to try it again? All right, so we see the litter, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. See the litter, pick it up, keep the earth clean. Make sure to recycle, recycle, recycle. Make sure to recycle, keep the earth clean. All right, very good. Okay, now we're going to read one more story, and then I'm going to show you how to make a really cool nature journal, okay? Because you're going to try to get out and walk around today and tomorrow. Well, today it's a little rainy, but if you can get out and you can collect things and you can draw things, and I'm going to show you how to hold all that and make a really cool memory book, okay? But our last book is a gorgeous book, and it is called Zonia's Rainforest. And this is by Juana Martinez Neal. She has won the Caldecott Honor. She has a lot of really great books, again, with Queen's Library. So you may want to check out Juana Martinez Neal, Zonia's Rainforest. And this is published by Candlewick Press. So we're going to thank Candlewick. Thank you. All right. I'm going to take the jacket off. And look at that beautiful cover. Actually, if you open it up, you could see how beautiful it really is. And on the inside, I see a lot and a lot of butterflies. That's right, you know. Okay, here we go. Zonia's Rainforest. And I'm gonna guess that that little girl is Zonia. Yep. Zonia lives with those she loves in the rainforest, where it is always green and full of life. Every morning, the rainforest calls to Zonia. Every morning, Zonia answers. Now, what do you think when the rainforest calls to her? What do you think it says? Maybe come and play? Right? How do you think it calls to her? Do you think it's the sound of the leaves blowing and maybe you hear some of the bugs buzzing? And how would she answer? By coming to play, very good. In Sonia's rainforest, green and full of life, she visits old friends and meets new ones. Good morning, she says, 1, 2, 3, 4 times. Do you know these guys? Oh, actually, 1, 2, 3, 4 times, and the butterfly was already there. These are sloths. Yeah. She stops to talk with some chatty new neighbors. Welcome. I live next door, Zonia sings. She says hello to her most playful friend. You are my favorite, Zonia whispers. If she is lucky, her fastest friend will invite her for a short ride through the thicket. We are mighty, Zonia says, for that is what she feels in her heart. Zonia sees a colorful couple swim by. How is the water today? She asks with a smile. She congratulates mamas with their new babies. I can't wait for you to meet my baby brother. I love him so much. Zonia loves playing hide and seek. 5, 6, 7, 8, she counts. Some friends help Zonia see the world in new ways. And Zonia knows just who to visit when she wants to be quiet and still. Who is she visiting? The turtles. Yeah, they just kind of hang out. After visiting all of her friends, Zonia is ready to go home. She can't wait to see her mama and baby brother again. Oh, no. On her way home, Zonia comes across something she has not seen before. The trees are gone. What happened to the trees? Let's see. Frightened, she runs the rest of the way home. Mama, look, Sonia says and opens her hands. The forest needs help. It is speaking to you, said Sonia's mama. Then I will answer, says Sonia, as I always do. We all must answer. Okay, now think about what that means. Think about, how would you answer? What is the forest calling her to do? Right? Maybe write a letter, maybe write a story about how to take care of the rainforest and how to save the planet. Very good. All right. So one of the ways we can do that, even though we don't live in a rainforest, is to make a nature journal. I have all different types of paper here. You can use plain paper. You can give it a nice construction paper cover. If you have a notebook for school, or, you know, and you can take a page out of here. But the point is, you take some paper, and I'm going to give myself a construction paper cover. And I'm going to fold it in half. And you can write your name on the cover. And whoops, I found this leaf outside yesterday. So you may want to stick whatever you find on it. Now, the big thing is just to get outside and walk around and see what you have around you. You can draw pictures. You can even use, this is my son's nature journal. And he has some dinosaurs and some plants. And as you can see, he has also pressed leaves in. Whoops. So he found these leaves in our neighborhood and he wanted to keep them. So he pressed them and they've become nice and flat. But they get really, really fragile. So you want to be careful. And you can glue them or you can keep them in a baggie. And then you just write what you see, stick things in that you've seen. If you see a really cool twig, if you see a really cool rock that you want to hold on to. My son has bags of rocks and shells and all sorts of things that he's found. So that's about that. And we're going to get ready to do our goodbye rhyme and our goodbye song, okay? So we're going to say, with my little hands, I clap, clap, clap. With my little feet, I tap, tap, tap. With my little arms, I wave bye, bye, bye. With my little legs, I kick high, high, high. With my little eyes, I play peekaboo. And with my little lips, I say, I love you. Now we're going to reach up and tickle the clouds. Reach down and tickle your toes. Now reach up and tickle your nose. Achoo. We're going to reach down low. We're going to reach up high. Story time's about to be over. So we're going to say goodbye. But first, we're going to do our goodbye song, which is just the opposite of our hello song. So we're going to say, goodbye, my friends, goodbye. Goodbye, my friends, goodbye. Goodbye, my friends, goodbye, my friends, goodbye, my friends, goodbye. Thank you, everybody. I see you soon. I miss you. Bye.